Do terpenes separate when mixed with extracts and distillate? Well, the answer is no, but we do have a lot of customers that are seeing separation in their pens. I'm going to explain to you the truth today about terpenes separating with extracts in this week's video, Terpenes and Distillate Separation from the Terpene Institute. My name is Drew, owner of MrExtractor.com, and my terpene profiles are in millions of products all around the country. One thing that we hear from some of our manufacturers and producers is that they're seeing some separation inside of their pens after they've mixed it with terpenes. And they, of course, would like to say, you know, this is a problem that we're having with the terpenes and some of these terpenes don't work, but that's not exactly what's happening. So I'm going to go ahead and show you what we see is happening because it's not that. So like I said, sometimes a manufacturer will get some of our terpenes and they'll mix it with their distillate or their BHO, and then they'll come back in like a few days and they'll look in their pen and they'll be like, oh man, this has got some separation issues in it. I'm seeing a dark layer at the top. It's not separating like water on top of oil, but they're seeing a difference in color. And they're like, dude, it's gotta be the terpenes. You know, sometimes I mix it with other terpenes and that doesn't happen. So I'm gonna, first up, let me take a break. I'm gonna put up a picture here of a customer that sent in this exact situation where they've mixed some of our product with their distillate. Take a look at their pen here. You can tell that there's a layer of darkness on top of there, and then there's a layer of lightness. And they're assuming that what's going on is that there's a separation of the terpenes, that the flavors they're using are separated. So I ran a bunch of tests because it's obviously a concern of ours. Everybody's making distillate in different ways. You know, who knows what people are doing out there. So we wanna make sure that our product is working well for everybody. So what I've got right here, let me get a close-up of this. What we've got right here is a jar of distillate, a little vial of distillate that I put here. It's about a half a gram. If you look real closely, you'll notice that there's a layer of dark right on the top of this distillate. Now, the thing about it is I haven't added any terpenes to this distillate. The distillate that I took it from was a large jar. It had it was a kilo of distillate, 1,000 grams, and it was all one color. So why am I seeing this light color with a dark layer on top? What that is indicative of is you overheating the distillate. Now, if you understand fractional distillation, what happens is you heat things to certain points and then they fractionalize. Different things come out at different points and different layers, and you siphon off the layer that you want. That's basic fractional distillation. What's happening here is we overheated the distillate, the larger jar, poured it into a lot of little jars, and as it sat, fractional distillation occurred and the darker part went to the top. Now that's the part that got burnt or overheated. So what we're seeing happening is that people are actually overheating their oil before they mix it into a pen. It looks all good inside inside the little vial that you're mixing. You pour it in your pen, and then over time those things separate by molecular weight or burning it or whatever that you did. It's not the terpenes that are separating out. You're not actually having a separation. Now, being that we probably carry right now 90 different profiles, and there's a bunch of different ingredients in all of them. Some of them are gonna have lower burn points and burn temperatures than others. So while you may have one set of terpenes over here that doesn't really actually burn at the temperature that you are heating it to, you use a different blend that has some more volatile terpenes or a flavoring agent in there, and you heat it up too high, you're gonna burn that. And then when you let it sit, it's gonna cool and separate. Having said that, like I said, this is pure distillate right here. There are no terpenes in it, and we're seeing the exact same problem in this, which means that you can burn the distillate itself. It's entirely possible that you didn't even burn any of our components. It's just your distillate. Now, we use the term distillate in a ballpark manner, and everybody likes to think of distillate the same, but there's different types of machines. There was different prior extraction methods, like some people extracted it with alcohol, some people extracted it with butane, how many passes you do. There's a whole bunch of different things to distillate. So I hate to say it, but using the word distillate really isn't that descriptive of a word, because like, what is it, the 10th pass, the first pass? Is it a mixture of things? You don't even know. So what I'm saying is that when you're heating something like that, you can have all these interactions occur that vary from batch to batch. Even if you're making your own batch, maybe you make your own distillate and you think everything's perfect. Maybe you just didn't do a good job on one run. I mean, that happens, man. I do. There's things I don't do a good job on once in a while. So what I would recommend is, if you're seeing that in your pens, don't automatically go to the terpenes. Understand you're probably overheating it, and I can pretty much guarantee it. If I'm having the same thing happen with no terpenes in it, that's from overheating. So try a lower heat setting, try it on smaller batches until you get it right. Try it on a smaller batch, wait a couple days, figure, and then try to mess it up. Try to do it wrong so you understand that point not to hit. Terpene Institute was just something I founded to make sure that everybody has a common sense understanding of terpenes, how to make money in this business and be successful. Make sure you go to the Terpene Institute and MrExtractor.com to learn more. Go make some money and go help some people. That's what it's about. You only got so much time left. This is Drew. I'll see you later.